Hello to all. Welcome to Global Offensive Hacker Associate Community and welcome to Offensive Cloud Pentesting Program. In this video, we are going to discuss about how we can use this Guacamole script, okay, and how to manage that particular infrastructure, okay, in the cloud environment. So, for example, let's say, like if you see here, this is my AWS dashboard. And if you can click here instances part, you see these are the instances, basically virtual machine I am running here. And after that, you see this CentOS machine where I deployed, okay, that part actually, which I want to show you. Just give me a minute. So this script we are using called Guacamole. Okay. So what I need to do is I need to use my IP address. First, I need to set up this one, okay, in my this environment called CentOS. I have successfully configured this machine. Let me show you. So let me just click here connect, and here is the IP address, right? This is the IP address of this machine. So go to the instances once again and copy that public IP addresses and going to paste here. Let's say this one. Okay, and I am just opening okay with this one. Okay, and after that you clearly see I am connected okay with the Ubuntu machine. So let me show you okay like properly how we can do that. So example, let's say I'll go here and then 8080. Let me copy this one and go to the Mozilla Firefox. Here I want to show you, right? This is the interface of this one. Okay, Guacamole. So if you see this part, there is a history tab and there is a user section and there is a connection. If you are handling this first time, this portal, you can simply go to the connections section. And if you see here right now, I'm not able to see any connection here, right? This one. So what I can do here is I can simply go to the new connection, this one. And you see here, okay, name. Example, let's say I want to connect it okay to the remote machine. So I'll use okay like example, it's Ubuntu Harshad. Any name okay you can give here, doesn't matter at all. And protocol, we have a SSH. And after that, okay, you see this is a proxy parameter, you leave it as it is. This is a parameter we require, host name. So what is the host name for this? So host name, okay, the machine which you want to connect. So I want to connect okay to Ubuntu machine. So let me show you, here is a Ubuntu machine. So let me go to instances and select this Ubuntu machine and connect it. If you see the IP address, okay, which is here 3132 something there, right? So let me go here and copy the public IP address of this Ubuntu machine and going to edit here. And then port number, you can see 22. And I don't have that username password because I have the key. So the key content, okay, you can copy from this section. Okay, so this is a key content. I'm just copying from this section. Okay. You simply copy this one key content, and after that you can simply go to the Firefox. So let me go to the Firefox section, okay, and going to copy this key content here, right? So this is a key I have added. Once you are done with this key part, we require username. So username, okay, basically we have Ubuntu. Okay, how we get to know about the username? Because when you go to this section, example, let's say this, connect to this machine, and here is Ubuntu is a username, okay? And after that, we don't have a passphrase, so simple, you can save it. And now it is saved. And you can clearly see I have two session here. One is Harshad and second is Ubuntu Harshad. What I can do is I can simple go to this section called this, and basically right hand side, and click on the home section. When you click on the home section, click on the Ubuntu Harshad, and you can clearly see we successfully connected okay to a particular server. So this technique is required okay when you are in the cloud environment, and if you are managing hundreds of server okay up and running. So I can't go directly okay to the system and server. So the admin have all the list of IP address, and he can connect like that. He can remotely manage each and everything. Now if you talk about pen testing side, so for pen testing side, for example, it's like I want to launch one machine with full configured all software. I can directly connect okay using this Guacamole web interface and I can connect to it, and then I can run directly all the software anywhere in the world. And this is the beauty of this particular framework. I hope you enjoy the video and see you soon in the next episode. Have a great day ahead.